Oh, hello. Just give me one moment, please. I hope you're doing well. Welcome to a very special video where I will be cleaning my balls that you see here to help you relax after a long, hard day of work, to help you sleep, especially if you have, you know, insomnia, to help you concentrate if you're working, whether it's at a job or you're painting or something along those lines, and possibly to help you to meditate. Now, before we get started, there's just a few things that I would like to say first. You probably noticed that I'm quite dressed up for, you know, something mundane like this, but this is quite a momentous occasion. I mean, aside from the fact that I want to help you relax, or, you know, or sleep, just like I said, this is actually the first time that I'll be cleaning, you know, my balls on camera. Not only that, but I've never cleaned these balls of mine. So I know you're probably thinking, you know, this is quite an elaborate setup, but, you know, it is a momentous occasion. If it wasn't, you know, if I wasn't doing this for you, you know, I would just clean my balls, you know, in the sink. Now, I know you're probably also thinking, wow, it must take a lot of balls to do a video like this. And, you know, honestly, it really doesn't. I'm not trying to show off my balls at all, you know. I don't want you to think I'm being pretentious. But, I mean, anyone can do a video like this. If you just have one pair of balls, if you just have one ball, you know, you could do a video like this. Maybe you don't have any balls. And, you know someone that does, and they have some balls that need to be cleaned, like your mom, or, you know, your sister, your friends, you know, whoever it might be. Maybe even your mom has more balls than your dad, you know? So, whatever the occasion might be, you know, it doesn't need, you don't really, there's no requirement. There's no ball requirement to do, you know, a video like this. Okay, with that said, I'm just going to go through here and show you the types of balls that I have, and show you some of the things that I'll be using to clean them. It looks like a very complicated process, but like I said, it's a special occasion. And, you know, I normally wouldn't do something like this in this manner, you know, off camera. Okay, so first up, we have this kickball. Not sure you can hear that, but this is a lot of fun. Of course, we use it to play kickball. And it's quite dirty, so that's going to need a good cleaning. I have this Wilson NFL football. See, this is quite dirty as well. Right there in the seam, or the seams, it's got quite a lot of dirt built up. So that's going to need a good cleaning as well. I have these tennis balls, and while I'm not quite the avid tennis player, from time to time we'll take the racket out. But these are quite dirty as well. I'm just trying to scratch these balls. You see the dirt, just the dust. These balls might be moldy as well, so it's going to need a good cleaning. Have this, looks like a official league baseball. And it's dirty as well. Oh, look at that. Looks like it's made in China. You don't see that too often these days. Oh, it's gonna need a good cleaning though. It's not quite as dirty as some of the others. And I have these pair of wiffle balls. One's dirtier than the other. But they'll need a good cleaning as well. I also have these pair of pool balls, a cue ball and an 8-ball. And they'll need a decent cleaning. They'll probably be a little bit more easier to clean than my other balls, because their surface is smooth, so the dirt that doesn't really have anywhere to sink into, really. A pair of golf balls. I'm not really much of a golfer at all. Once in a while, go to those little practice places just to see how far you can hit the ball. But I've honestly never stepped 1 foot onto a golf course, and honestly, I don't really regret not doing that. They're just not my thing, but they're dirty regardless, so we need to clean those. And lastly, a pair of these are ping pong balls or table tennis balls. And you can see how dirty these balls are. Oh, look at that, made in China. So when I said you don't see that too often, well, there you go. Okay, I also have these pair of nitrile, I don't really know how to pronounce that, gloves, disposable. And I bought these specifically to aid in, you know, to keep my hands clean while I, you know, clean my dirty balls. High quality latex free nitrile material. I feel like saying nitrile, but one size fits all. They're a high quality latex free nitrile material. Textured grip, durable strength, puncture resistant. Resists most household cleaners, which is very important. Lightly powdered for easy on and off, and extra length. It also says here, lightly powdered with 100% cornstarch dusting powder. Now look at this. Made in Vietnam. I wonder how much they get paid to the folks over in China. So, I might as well take a pair out right now. Alright, put those there. I'm just going to set this package aside. Of course, I also have this scrub brush. It's a really nice sound. You can use a scrub brush to clean your balls, you know, washcloth, there's so many different ways, but I'm gonna use this because the, you know, the handle, and yeah, I think it might do a good job. Now I also have this bowl of water. This is after I use a cleaner to clean my balls. I'm gonna dunk my balls into this bowl of water, you know, to rinse them. Like I said, this is a pretty elaborate way, you know, to clean balls. But like I said, it's a special occasion. Now I have a bottle of bleach here. It's concentrated. It removes it removes 80% more stains, 10 times deep cleaning benefits, 33% more cleaning solution, brightens, whitens, and deodorizes. So I think I have another bowl over here that I'm going to bring up here in a minute. I think what I'm going to do first is dunk my balls into a bowl of bleach. You know, get them nice and cleaned. And then rinse my balls off in this nice clean water, bowl of water. Now, I also have... I brought along this stripper. It is a premium sprayable stripper. It's, you know, works in less than 15 minutes. Removes multiple layers of any finish. You know, it strips paint, epoxy, and polyurethane from wood, metal and masonry. So I thought it might be a good idea to use this, but the more I think about it, I don't really think dipping or dunking my balls into the stripper is a good idea. I don't know where the stripper has been. I don't know, you know, who used the stripper before me. So I just don't think it's going to be a good idea. I don't even know how old that stripper is. So the last thing I need to do is to dunk my balls into there and, you know, just cause some adverse effects and do more harm than good. All right, so let's get that other bowl up here. And let me get this. I don't know about you, but I always like that sound. Okay, so I'm just gonna pour some of this in here. That's pretty powerful stuff. So we're gonna move that bleach over there. Okay. And of course I have a nice clean towel so I can, you know, dry off my balls, you know, pat my balls dry when I'm done, you know, cleaning them and rinsing them. All right, so. Just put that over here. That. Okay. Let's get my gloves on here. And if you haven't fallen asleep yet, or not, you're still listening to what I'm saying. Feel free, if you like, to leave a comment. Let me know, you know, how often, you know, have you ever cleaned your balls, if you have balls? You know, how often do you clean them? You know, if you don't have any balls, do you clean anybody else's? Those fit pretty well. And seems like a lot of work, doesn't it? A lot of effort to go through just to clean my balls, but like I said, some nice sounds right here. let's start off with the kickball. And let's get some of that bleach. And I'm just going to rest the ball on the side here, on the rim. Over here. I'm just gonna back away a little bit so I don't breathe it in so much. Okay, and let's just dunk this ball in here. You can see how much dirt has come off of it. Shake it a little bit. Let's just rinse it off. leech out of the way. Let's just get this mall dried off here. We can set it down. Is new. Football cleaned off next. You can see how dirty and grimy this ball is. All right, let's try to rinse this off. Now again, this would have been much easier if I just cleaned this football, now in the sink or with a hose. But it's all about trying to help you relax and sleep. Okay. All right. makes two balls then. Let's work on the tennis balls. Let me just dunk these into the bleach like this. Yeah, I think that's a little better. Let's rinse it off here. You know, it's probably a better idea to use some soap. You know, because these balls are so dirty, I just thought it'd be better if I just, you know, dunked them in bleach. That's a lot better. See that? Look how well it cleaned up. So let's do the same with the other one. Get that bleach. And we'll just it off here. Coming along nicely. That one's pretty cleaned up as well. It's probably the best that I'm gonna get it. But it's better than nothing. Okay, now we have the baseball here. I'm just gonna move this ball a little bit further away from my face. Let's just scrub this. It's got a nice smooth surface. I know this bleach is getting dirty, but it's not going to lose its potency, really. Okay. And we'll give this a good rinse. white that ball is. Nice and clean. Alright. Let's get these wiffle balls cleaned up. That one came out pretty nice as well. Nice and clean. Do the next one. That one came out really nice and clean. Okay. Alright, I don't need, I don't think I'm going to need to scrub these pool balls. They're not porous, so the dirt's not going to really, you know, get in there and stick so much. And what's great about balls like these is you can just, you know, hold them in your hand and dunk them right into the bleach together. And if you're new to cleaning balls like this, you know, don't be afraid to dunk your balls into a bowl of bleach. Right now, I'll just rinse my balls off here in the water. I'm just kind of scrub the balls with my hands. There we go. Shake off some of the water. And we'll just pat the balls dry. Just leave this here, I guess. There we go. Nice clean pair of pool balls. Bleach is getting my eyes just a little bit. It's all right though. Okay, you know what? I think I'm done dunking my balls into bleach. That was fun while it lasted. It's kind of starting to irritate my eyes a little bit. So. You could always forgo the bleach and just, you know, dunk your balls into a bowl of, you know, soapy water. It's probably the, you know, it might take a little bit more work to clean them, but, all right. I got these pair of golf balls. Now I'm just going to hold these balls in my hand like this. And I just scrub them. These particular pair of balls of mine are definitely more dirtier than my own balls. Taking a little bit more elbow grease to clean them. Okay. Thank you. just dunk these balls into the water. Right. There we go. Pretty close to brand new. To the last pair of balls. These are probably the smallest balls that I own. Actually, that's not true. I have those wooden, very small wooden balls. They have like beads. They have holes drilled right through the center. If I need to scrub them. And just a little bit. Set that one down. Okay. Let me just dunk my balls here, rinse them off in the water. Just kind of massaging my balls a little bit, scrubbing them. Dry my balls off, pat them dry. And there you have it. A pair of nicely cleaned tennis balls. Table tennis balls. It's a great sound, isn't it? Side-by-side comparison from when my balls were dirty in the beginning to how clean they are now. All right, so on the left, you can see how dirty my balls were in the beginning when we first started. And now on the right, in comparison, you can see how clean my balls are. Quite a difference. Okay, well, I hope you found this to be relaxing. Hopefully, maybe you're even asleep at this point. I also hope that maybe you found this to be informative, too, so that, you know, like I said in the beginning, whether or not you have your own balls that need to be cleaned, you know, here's just one way of doing that. It's kind of a lot of work. It's quite an elaborate way for someone to clean their balls, but like I said, this was a very special occasion. So, thanks again for tuning in. And until next time, take care and hope to see you in another video real soon. Bye-bye. Those are some really clean balls.